Welcome back. In today's Fame and Fortune, we're going to take an inside look at those Emmy nominations, which were out this week. Among the shows, WandaVision and Hamilton setting records. We've got Allie Cannell here with all those details. Allie?
That's right, Alexis. Streaming was the big winner here when it came to these Emmy nominations. If we take a look at the network wins, we have HBO, along with its fledgling streaming service, HBO Max, leading the way with 130 nominations. Netflix was in second with 129 nods. And two-year-old Disney Plus came in third with 71 nominations, whereas traditional cable network NBC finished fourth with just a mere 46 nominations, so way behind the others. And then rounding out the top five, we have Apple TV Plus with 37 total nods, largely thanks to the breakout comedy series Ted Lasso. Ted Lasso earned 20 nominations, right up there with the most nominated shows, which also went to streaming. We had Netflix's The Crown with 24 nods, Disney Plus's The Mandalorian also with 24 nods, and WandaVision, as you mentioned, coming in third, secure 23 nominations. And this was the first time in Emmy's history that the top three most nominated shows came from streaming platforms, whereas we saw nods for traditional cable or broadcast networks experiencing all-time lows in the comedy category. For example, ABC's Black-ish was the only non-streamer to be nominated. So right now we're seeing this streaming dominance. I did have a chance to speak with ComScore senior media analyst Paul DeGarabedian about this. And he said the reason that we're seeing these things right now is because streaming, they have the resources to really put the money where their mouth is, and they're able to allow these creatives the creative freedoms that they want. For example, if you take a look at Netflix, they just inked a multi-year deal with Steven Spielberg. They shelled out $450 million to secure the next two Knives Out sequels. We also have Disney Plus, which will be the home for the new Beatles documentary, essentially stealing that from theaters this upcoming Thanksgiving. So, you know, I think that they are able to do things a little differently than cable. They're able to provide those freedoms. They're able to provide the money and the infrastructure that these creatives want in order to create the best quality content. So we'll see where the things go from here. But I will say, streamers have been nominated in the past, and they don't necessarily go on to win. So that's something that I'll be watching really closely, although it looks like the odds are in their favor from all of these nominations.